Hey folks, Duke CT here back once again. And before I get this video started, I want to tell you that today is your lucky day. My live stream, that's right, my 4 p.m. Eastern Standard Time live commentary of Land Before Time 13 Wisdom of Friends will be happening today. No, there will be no BS what happened. It will happen at 4 o'clock p.m. Eastern Standard Time. We'll start there. And I'm gonna look at the look at my old video, commentate on it and everything else, have a couple laughs and everything else. After that, I'm just gonna have a little bit of fun on live stream. Hopefully you can join me. Link is in the description. And hopefully you can join me and we can all have a bit of fun. Anyway, this video, as you can look at the title, it says basically, well, Matt Morgan may be going back to the WWE. From NoDQ.com, and Matt Morgan stated this in a live cast. I think that's something of radio or something, a program, what have you. He said this, that his contract, that once his contract with TNA is up later this year, he may be heading back to the WWE. Link to the story is in the description. And I'm going to read some of it for you. I have and he's quoting, and I quote, he says right here, I have another year left on my contract with TNA, he said. My fifth of 5 years. I signed a 5-year deal with them 4 years ago. I believe in October it will be up. The way it works is I'm a businessman first and foremost, right? And you try to keep your options open as much as humanly possible. I did start with WWE. They gave me a lot of tools and a lot of knowledge, and I was trained by some of the best big men this business has ever had, and learned a lot of things from those people over there at the WWE. So I was very lucky. Okay, but you know what? But this right here is really telling. It's about his whole being part of the layoffs that happened in 2005. Here's what's something interesting. He says, unfortunately, unluckily, I came there during a time when there was a revolving door. The day I got released, I believe we lost 22 other guys in a 2-day span on a Thursday, as well as Black Friday in 2005. I believe it was one of those wrong places, wrong time. Timing is everything in this sport. So, with all that said, do you think he's going to re-sign with TNA? I would think, honestly, I wouldn't be surprised if he does resign, but if he does not and goes to WWE, I think WWE could use him immensely. Because let me tell you something. He's young. He's very mobile as a big man. And I think he can actually, let me be honest with you. He's a lot more, he's a lot better in a match. A lot better in the ring than, say, the great Khali and everything else. I think he could be the next heir apparent. And, for the big show, what have you. I think that could have been something like that. I really thought when you look at someone like Matt Morgan, I see tons of potential. I see someone who could really be something very positive for WWE. If WWE can get him, I think it would be really good. You get a young big man who knows the ropes and what have you. And he really does have the basics right down. And I think TNA has dropped the ball on him many a times. I think he should have beat Kurt Angle, BFG 2010? Yes, in 2010. He should have beat Kurt Angle. I don't know why they didn't do that. It was really stupid. And TNA has the opportunities to push him, and yet they just, leave him to die for whatever reason. And they just put him everything else in these stupid feuds and everything else instead of pushing. They push Sting and everything else instead of pushing talent like Matt Morgan, who honestly, I felt like, you know what, this guy could be your big star. This could be someone you could really franchise. So WWE really made a stupid mistake for letting this guy go, and TNA could have made him to one hell of a star. And don't get me wrong, I love Bobby Roode. I love James Storm, all these other guys, but this is another problem with TNA. Besides Christian Cage or what have you, can you tell me and what have you and Kurt Angle and everything else? Can you tell me, when's the last young TNA, young WWE star TNA has made their own, or like put that stamp and say push that guy. I mean, I could disqualify Angle because he was pretty, you know, old or what have you. I honestly thought when you look at someone like Matt Morgan, I say the Pope, D'Angelo De Niro, or you know, all the other guys who came from WWE who were young and talented and everything else, and they just don't work out for whatever reason. It really bothers me. It really does. This shows that WWE, it shows TNA that they rather care for these people who are older, like more see, like, you know, maybe a lot more seasoned, maybe a lot more. What's the word? Oh, a lot more recognizable, a lot more, you know, Sting, Kurt Angle, and everything. You know, that sort of thing. I have no problem with that. I have no problem with them trying to branch out and try to, you know, push guys who, let's be honest, are more well known. Some people may be against it, and I can see what the TNA is trying to do. But you cannot make them the true focus of your show. You cannot make them the focus to the point that it's a detriment to the other guys. It feels like if you push them to the point that, like, without Sting, you know, AJ Styles will never get over, and, you know, we've never moved on and what have you. We never did that A, B, C, or the other. That's the problem. You have these guys who are believe, like, you put AJ Styles, you know, in this, like, you have him join out with every WWE washout. You know, that's really sad. You have, you know, or, for example, you just make them completely irrelevant. You make the guys who are building everything else completely irrelevant to the WWE or, you know, our old WCW stars. That's the main problem with this company. And it's a shame. It's really a shame when you have someone who could have been a really big star, who could have been something really positive for this company, are just going to say, you know what? Be like what Christian is. They say, you know what? Even Christian was pushed right. Who was built up to be a champion. I honestly thought his championship runs were good and actually had some really good matches. But he left. The first chance he got, he rolled back into WWE. And, well, yeah, we all know what happened there. But when you see someone like Matt Morgan, who could have been something really good, and now he's going to go right back to WWE, and with all of these statements, I see him going to WWE. And really pushing him to become, honestly, the next big man. I think he has at least a couple, five, six, 7 more years. It, I mean, you know, he only had one injury, what have you. And he's not really that injury prone. It's just like the TNA doesn't know how to book him right. I have a feeling that this guy could be something really positive. And if WWE picks him up and books him well, which I see what they're doing. They are trying to get new faces in and push everyone else. I think someone like him, WWE may... They may fumble the ball, like, at the end of a storyline, but at least they actually make, you know, they make strides. They actually make, you know, they get to the red zone. TNA, they barely get, when they get to the red zone, without screwing things up, it's a miracle. TNA, I just don't know how, I don't know how they book the way they do. It's just amazing how they screw up the simplest things. But with WWE, it's a longer, you know, they get to the goal line, they get to the red zone and goal line, but, you know, most of the time not, they, you know, they can try to get a touchdown, but more times than not, they get a field goal. If not, you know, they don't, and usually sometimes fumble the ball, but at least they get to the red zone, at least they get to the goal line. And that's what I think is going to happen. I think that's what I say. He's going to go to WWE, and Matt Morgan's career is going to be a lot better for it. And TNA is going to look back, and they're going to see another guy they could have made into a huge star, you know, for football. For whatever reason, they just couldn't do it. Anyway, that's all I got to say here. Dixie T here. Peace and love. Don't forget, live stream, 4 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. I'll see y'all when I see y'all. Later.